So I want to switch gears and back up. I've done a lot of talk about self-worth, core story. There's other stories going on here. I want to talk about the story of time. I want you to imagine someone starting a business in their 20s, okay? And they're really successful. Maybe they can do the sales calls, they can do all that stuff. And let's say their first goal is, I want to make 50 grand in the next 3 months. And they hit it. They get there and it feels pretty good and they go, you know what, I want to make 100 grand in the next 9 months. And they hit it. Like, okay, doesn't feel that different, but I got it. Like, let's go for a million. Let's do a million. Over the next year, they do a million. Now they're in their 30s and they're totally focused on success and they're winning at success. They're absolutely able to succeed. They can have businesses and have all these things happen, but you know, maybe other areas of their life aren't good. You've seen the CEO who's fat and balding and treats his wife like shit and you know is just not really happy, not connected or arrived at all, hasn't actually gotten to a goal that made a difference, because every time he got to a goal, there was another goal. It just, we made the numbers bigger. Because if you make 500,000, a million doesn't really feel that different. If you make 200,000, a million doesn't really feel that different. And so how many CEOs, how many people on our planet are just constantly chasing this goal, but without any real ability to land in a deep appreciation of arrival, of I actually feel like I'm here. I actually feel like I'm presently doing what I'm doing. So successful, but never satisfied, right? This is not what we want. There's two things that are going on in this world. There's being, literally being present here, fully arrived and awake. And there's doing, right? Doing is mastering the science of success, knowing how to go out and be successful. And we want to do that, of course. But if we only do that, we never master the art of fulfillment, the art of being. So back up and look at your life and see yourself doing it the wrong way. See yourself chasing goal after goal after goal after goal after goal, because nobody gets out of here alive, guys. We're all dead. We're all dead. You have this gift, this little bit of time on this planet, and it's a gift. And I'm going to show you a slide in a second. This is not dress rehearsal. We're not pretending now to get to the more realized version of ourself later when we have the money or the girl or the car or the whatever. This is it. It never changes from this. There actually is no time. It's always now. So if you're not very good at being in the now, if you're constantly, this is not enough, I don't have enough money, all this, if that's your experience of now, I'm going to suggest you're failing. So what if you never arrived? What if you were constantly living into this idea of the future? What if you were constantly trying to get there instead of being here? And the whole thing expires and you chased it the whole time. It's what I call being stuck on the treadmill of time. Chase and chase and chase, and one day I'll get there. It's also a cycle of becoming. I'm not enough yet, so I need to become more. I'm not enough yet, so I need to become more. Again, this is not dress rehearsal. This is life. You're in it now. So the story of time, right? If we back up, we've got core story. I'm going to go through some more stories after this. The story of time is I'm not there yet. And look at how it relates to the not enough core story. Look at how it relates to that. If I'm not there yet, my house isn't good enough yet. I don't have enough money yet. I'm not pretty enough yet. My friends aren't good enough yet. And what does that do? It actually creates time. Now is not okay because I'm not there yet. So why would I want to be in the now? I'm not enough in the now, so I have to become more. I better get over there. So I did a little bit of this on a call with you guys at some point. If you'll do it again with me, I would really appreciate it. Could we actually center and get into our breath? And we're going to play with time just a little bit. Everybody adjusts. I love that. So we're going to take a few breaths together, and I'm just going to try and name what the different parts of time are so that we get a little bit of a kind of common angle on this. So we're going to find presence first. And presence is a huge, big thing. We're just going to find parts of it. So all together, it's really special to all breathe together. Why don't we take deep breaths in, and I'm going to ask you to hold at the top for a while and then let it out, and I'll just guide us for 3 or 4 breaths, okay? So I'll take a deep breath in together. And hold it at the top, as much air as you can take in. Hold it, hold it, hold it. And let it out and feel your body tingle and relax into your chairs. If you haven't already, I'm going to invite you to close your eyes. Take another deep breath in with me. Hold it, hold it. A little more. Okay, let it out. And sink deeply into your chair. Let's all take one more big breath together. And let it out. And I want you to start to enter into your internal space. Just look for any sensations and feelings. You might notice the sound of that fan. You might notice what the air feels like on your skin in the room. I'm going to name this presence. We're not in thought right now. You hear the sound of my voice. You feel the weight of your body in the chair. And you're fully here. There's nowhere else to be. And so we're going to anchor that as a literal place in your experience, in your mind. And now I want to take you to another place. I want you to go back to when you were maybe 10, 11 years old. I want you to fully go back to the past. I want you to imagine maybe playing with friends. Maybe you're hanging out with your family. Pick your favorite memory. And really build it up, really go there as deeply as you can. Go to the past. Hold that image for just another second, and we're going to call this the past. We're having a memory, we're going into the past. And now I want you to build the skill of dropping. Drop that and come back to your breath. Big breath in together. And center back. And thoughts may come, and that's fine, but just let them go and get back into your body, back into presence. And so here we are back in presence. You can hear the fan, and you can be still. And notice that it feels very different than when you were in the past. You can feel your body. Now let's go out maybe 3 years into the future. I want you to see wild success for yourself. See the business that you're trying to start just taking off. See yourself hanging out with influential, important, maybe famous people. I want you to smell the flowers that are nearby somewhere, making the room or the place smell really nice. I know when I go to my future, there's a beach nearby. I want you to really create that and get connected to that future. See as many details as you can. Listen to the sounds of the future, what's going on around you. Smell the smells, taste the taste in your mouth in the future. Really connect with it. And notice that you're not as connected to the present when you're there, because this is the future. Now we're going to drop that, come back to the past one more time. Just take a deep breath and get really skilled at dropping thoughts and just being present. Nice breath. Be back in your body, back in your seat, back with the fan. I want to take you to one more place. I want to take you into imagination. I want you to imagine you step into a helicopter, take up off away from this place, and you're flying up high in the sky, and you look down and you can see where the foundation event is being held. You can see the college campus beneath you. And then you actually realize that you can fly. So you happily jump right out of the helicopter and start to soar up into the sky. Up, up, higher away, looking back at the earth, farther and farther away. And you can fly as fast as you want in any direction, go anywhere you want. keep floating around for just another minute. Notice that while you do that, you're a little less connected to your breath. You're not as much in the room because you're in your imagination. And so you can drop that and you can come back into the room, and I suggest we all just open our eyes and take a big breath together. And I want you to feel the different quality that's in the room right now, just getting connected to presence for a little bit. Sometimes it feels like I can actually like pry open and go into a much deeper, richer reality. Maybe you can still feel the air on your skin. Maybe you can feel a little bit more calm, that there's less story and running around going on in your brain. Now, what I want to point out about that visualization is that there is no past. Nobody in the room went into the past. And in fact, if I were to challenge you, I would imagine that you had to construct your past quite a bit. You did your best, you saw green grass, you thought of this, parts weren't there, you added a face, there was an energy of a person, whatever that is. You did your best to construct a past, but it was an imagination. You were still here, I could see you, I was talking to you. You never left now. The future that you guys imagined, it's another imagination, isn't it? We didn't go to the future. It's a powerful visioning tool. We can think about doing things differently by going there, but you never went anywhere. There is no past and future. There is no place to go other than here. The past is an imagination. The future is an imagination, and we have another imagination, right? That's just the use of imagining when we know we're doing it. But we live in imagination all the time, most of us. Very few of us have a deep connected, you know, connection to presence and embodiment. Very few of us walk and feel what our feet feel like on the ground. And we have ideas and stories about even what enlightenment is, that it's some hippy-dippy thing and we can't actually engage in the world or do all that. We can actually master being and doing. And I want to redefine enlightenment to look like that, because just being present doesn't leave us powerful enough in the world to address the problems that we have. We have to write new stories about what these things mean, okay? We live in imagination when all joy lives in the now. Everything you do that's joyful happens now. The sex you have, the laughing with friends, the hanging out. You can imagine joy in the future, but you don't experience it unless you're right here feeling it. There's no such thing as a future accomplishment that will do anything. This is not dress rehearsal for when it's real later. That's the story of time. That's the illusion that we're telling ourselves about time. And we're all living in imagination with these crowded, you know, brains that the past is guilt and shame and the future is fear and anxiety. That's what's going on. That's what we're living in. So without the ability to presence, without that, we're just living on this hamster wheel, this treadmill of time, this cycle of becoming. And like a muscle that you wouldn't use, if you don't actually work to actually be present, people that don't meditate, ask them to sit for 10 minutes, it's like an eternity. Right? It's like the most painful thing you could have them do, because that part of their brain has atrophied. They got caught in the story of the world and they are lost in time. So one of the things you may want to take away from this talk is that some type of presencing practice is really, really powerful. Your best ideas will come from that. Your joy will come from that, just that little thing, you know, that whole like being happy thing. I don't know if anybody really is into that, but whatever. But if you don't do it, it's harder to get back to, okay? So our minds running and running and running, never getting there, right? We never get there. We keep doing these goals, and even if we accomplish them, there's just another goal after that. We never get there because there is no there. There's no such thing. It's an imagination. Where we need to get is here. We actually need to get here. Because if we can get here as confident, whole, happy people that are telling stories that are empowered about ourselves and the world, everything changes. Everything changes for us personally, and everything can change for the whole world. We need to get here. And don't mistake the story of the Buddhist that doesn't do anything else and just sits on a rock all the time. You can be here and be incredibly impactful and profound in the world. In fact, I think you'll be more so when you learn how to be here. So with a core story of not enough, sitting in presence is painful, right? If I don't think I'm enough and I ask someone to meditate, they're like, I'm not there yet. I'm not doing it good enough. It's horrible. It's like a nightmare. Their brain doesn't stop. Where am I supposed to be? Because I'm not enough here, so I don't want to be here. So it's going to be very hard to meditate if you have the core story of I'm not enough, or this isn't enough, or the world is scary, because it's not going to be okay here, because we're going to try and get to that fiction future where everything's better.